Hello and welcome to this tutorial. In this tutorial I want to show you how we enter and exit a car in a third person character. So you walk to the car, get in, could drive around and get out again. So the first thing we have to do is set up some variables, and I have also created animation for sitting in the car. So let's go to our test car. That's the test car from the last tutorial, but you can use any car you want. And the first variable we need is can enter. That is a boolean. And we also need an active, or just say driver. That's okay. So the type will be that we search for third person character and we need an object reference, so that's fine. And then we go back to our third person character, so that's the typical character, I didn't change anything. And also we need two variables here, so the first thing will be active car. And the second thing will be in car as a boolean. So we have to change our active car to test car object reference. Then we go back to our test car and we go to the viewport because we need two things. So the first thing will be a box collision. I call this just enter box. Put it right here, something like that. No, that's okay. Much a little bit bigger. Okay, so that it would be recognized. So the second thing is we need a text and put this to the mesh. Let's call this enter text. Pull it up here, go to the driver's seat, turn it around so that the player can see the text, and I just put the text to enter car. A little better right here. Great. So the next thing that we have to do is put this text to invisible because it didn't show up. It shouldn't show up the whole time. Then we go back to our event graph, and what we need now is we need our enter box. So when we go to the enter box and say event begin overlap, took this out here, and then we say cast to third person character. Put the other actor right here. Then we get our enter text, set visibility. I put this to true. Then we can go from as third person character and say set active car. Put this inside here, say self, get the reference to self. So self in this case is the test car. Put this inside here. So now the test car would be set as an active car for the third person character. And then we take our boolean that we created, say set, put this inside here and say that's true. So this is the try enter car function. Compile and save that. And what we have now is when I play and I go to the car, you can see the text appears. So, but it will still there if we leave it. So we need another function for that. So in this case, we go back to our viewport go to the enter box and say on component and overlap, and then we just say our enter text is set visibility to false, so let's keep it right there, and the can enter will be also set to false, so that's the cancel enter function. So what it does is when we compile and save that, we go to the car, we see the text, and when we go out the box, it disappears. So the next thing we need is we go to project settings, go to input, and we need two functions. So hit plus and say enter car. Let's put this to the E key, and then we need another function and say leave car, and put this also to the E key. You can choose whatever you want, but let's keep that. So we go back to our third person character and say enter car. Then we need our active car, say get. Then we need a branch from repress it. From the active car we say get can enter. And we put it to the condition, so it already checks if we can enter the active car. Then we say get player controller. So and on true we go from our active car and say set driver, put this to true, and then we say self, get the reference to self, in this case it is the third person character, put this into the driver, and from this get player controller we say pulses, proceeds, I don't know, get this to here, and from the active car into port. So we want to control the car when we get into the car. So the next thing, we go from self and say set actor enable collision. Of course, if we don't set this, yeah, the car would just flip around. So we put this inside here and leave it to false. So now we have to attach the driver to the car. So we go to the skeleton mesh of the car. In this case, it's the hatchback. And we say right click, add socket. Let's call this driver seat. Copy the name of that. Then we go back to our third person character and say attach actor to actor. Paste the socket name right here that we created. Then we go from our active car, put this into the parent actor. And the last thing, we have to get our boolean in car and set this to true. Then we have to put the location rule to snap to target and also the scale and rotation. And let's call this enter car. Great. Compile, save, let's test it. So when we play, go to the car, hit E, and we control the car and drive around. So, but we now need a function to leave the car. So we go to our test car and say right click, leave car. So first thing also need is get player controller. We need our driver, so we say get. And from this we need pulses, press is true. The driver is going to porn. And then we go from the driver and say get actor, where is location, right click, split structure pin. Then we say driver set actor location, also here right click, split, put this to Z, this to Y, and for the X we say float minus float, put this to X, put this like 100. So the reason for that is when you leave the car, you want to stay by the car and not in the car. So we have to set the value minus 100, so it will go be next to the car. So put this to here. The next thing, we go from the driver and say set actor enable collision, because we want to re-enable the collision that we deactivated on enter. Put this inside here, and of course if we have attached the driver, we have to detach the driver. So let's say detach from actor, put this to here and say keep world and keep world. So the last thing is we go again from the driver and say set in car to false, because he left the car. So this will be the leave car function. So let's go back to our skeleton mesh and put the driver's seat more into position. So like that. And when we now hit play, we hit E to enter the car, and when we now hit E again, we are next to the car, and we can do that whenever we want. So, but the last thing we have to do is that the character really sit into the car, so we need a few things for that. We go to our third person animation blueprint, and we need a variable, so that says in car, and we go to our third person character. We have also the in car boolean right here, so we have to connect this into the animation blueprint. So from here we say carst to third person character, put this to here, and then as third person character we say get in car boolean, set this here. Great. So compile and save that. Then we go to our animation graph, and from the idle we go out, add state, call this in car, and from in car to idle and run again. Then from idle car, from the idle into the car, we just put the boolean out, put it right here, compile and save, and from in car to the idle run we do the same. So get, then we say not boolean, because we want go out of the car, and the animation will be the sitting animation that I created. Put this right here. Compile and save that. So, and when we now hit play, go to the car, enter, and as you can see, he sits into the car, yeah, but we have to fix that a little bit because it looks a little bit stupid. So let's put it up to here, a little bit down, save that. And if we now go into it again, yeah, that looks a little bit better, but something like that. No, that's okay. So, now you can see we drive around, sit in the car, press E again, get out, get in again, drive around. So, I hope you enjoyed the tutorial, and if you have any questions, please let me know, and yeah, goodbye.